RSL gets their first ever win in Vancouver, 1-0. And we welcome you back into tonight's post-game show, brought to you by Ford, the Ford F-Series, the number one selling truck in America.
Time you
for 36 years straight. See your local Ford store or thinkfordnow.com for all the details. Bill Riley and Brian Dunseth upstairs here on the Ford post-game show. We're joined downstairs by the head coach of Real Salt Lake, Jason Christ. First of all, Jason, congratulations. We've heard all year, and we've talked to you all year long about how deep your team is, and we've talked about it on a number of occasions. Was today the greatest confirmation you've had with the depth of your team?
Yes. I'm just so extremely happy for and proud of those gentlemen out there that put an unbelievable fight for us today and put us back into a spot where perhaps we can challenge for the supporter shield.
Yeah, Jason, we talked about in the pregame saying that, you know, this is probably the most realistic approach for you in probably the least ideal situation with such a short turnaround time. But does it maybe play in your favor knowing that now you've got guys that put it in the back of your head that these guys can make a difference? These guys can play.
Yeah. I told the players yesterday that I think that for me this was all about just opportunity. There was no reason to be fearful. There was no reason to come here thinking that we may lose. Just go out there and give it everything you have. And if we come away with a result, you'll have helped the team tremendously, just both with the points and also to put us back into winning ways going into Tuesday night. So if we can roll another result out Tuesday night, I think we can put ourselves in a terrific, terrific place heading into the playoffs.
You know, Jason, you had your ninth different starting center back combination tonight across all matches this year. But, you know, Jeff gets the clean sheet, and rightfully so, he was terrific. But if you could talk just a little bit and give us your thoughts on the play of the back four from Palmer to Mansalli on the outside and McDonald and Schuler on the inside.
I thought they were all terrific. I mean, we had a few tactical situations in the first half where outside backs were playing too far in, but I thought we sorted that out better in the second half. And the center back pairing, Schuler was excellent, McDonald was excellent, Atanella was really, really spot on for us, and he made the huge save in the first half when we needed him to and came off his line really well throughout the match.
Jason, congratulations. We'll see you in just a bit, and we'll certainly see you on Tuesday night. Thanks.
Hey guys, I want to interject one thing if I could.
Head coach Jason Christ with us here.
Go ahead, Jay.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Jay.
Just yesterday when I got off the bus, I knew that we were in a really lucky place because somebody had borrowed their wife or daughter's bag.
Oh, really lucky bag.
Thank you very much, Bill Riley. Welcome to you.
Thank you, Jason.
I gotcha.
It's the green bag. The green bag. That is always.
Did you see the smile on his face? He was so excited to pull that one off.
He just set me up.
He called you out.
He gave me such grief yesterday getting off the bus. He said, "Whose green bag is this?" I said, "Green's my favorite color, and you can find it coming off the baggage carousel very easily."
I'll give you a hug during the commercial. That's okay. That was a good one.
That one stung a lot.
Purchase your tickets now for the U.S. Open Cup final at Rio Tinto Stadium on October 1st at 7.